have migrated myself back indoors. You know, I just figured it was a very cold ride on Wednesday. It was said to be, the forecast said 3+, and it felt like 0. And needless to say, I was battling a pretty stiff headwind for most of the time because it was a northeastern wind. So you have like a whole belt, you know, from the north all the way to the east of just cold wind, you know, hitting my face. So it was simply horrible. I biked for 60, I think it was a 60k ride, and I could only muster a mere 24 kilometer average, you know, as in speed. So that was pretty bad. Been trying to make the most of that, just making some comments along the way and just doing my best. I have somewhat to go. But do check out some of those. You don't have to look at everything, you know, it's just, there's some good places to ride. So if you want to ride here, I've been all over the place, so I know where to ride and not to ride. There's a lot of good roads around. A lot of asphalt, a lot of new asphalt too, and there's some bad roads too, so if you want to do some research, do that and come for a ride. Plenty of roads. Okay, so I had to migrate back to Swift. You know, honestly, I could have skipped the entire thing, but I was sort of missing Swift a little bit. Honestly, I was missing it. I was missing the races. And then I thought, well, it's a Friday. I usually, you know, ride on a Friday. It's, you know, it was snowing this morning, so why not go online? But then I encountered another problem. We seem to be out of connection to the internet. So what I had to do, I'm using my old phone as an access point. It's 5G, I think, but well, it's a cell phone, and I've connected the game to it, and that's fine and dandy. But then I encountered another problem, and that is for Companion to work, and here's the tip, it needs to be on the same network. And then I needed to connect my other phone to my old phone, so everything runs through the old phone. For those of us who are used to calling those things for routers or routers, this is a whole new ballgame. So everything's pulled through that thing, and I have to connect it to a power source at least to make sure that it won't run out. And God knows how much this will cost. Usually I have a lot of gigabytes available, so it doesn't care. I don't care. It doesn't mean anything. I just want to go. I just want to ride. But the net is down, which is ironic. Been fine all season, and then I'm just gonna do an extra ride and it's off. Probably nothing to worry about. Just you take the power, you take it off, and you plug the power back in. But well, you can do that, or you can walk around and wonder why the net is off. So when I get back, I have to take the power supply on the Google thing network and take the power off and then put the power back on, and I think we'll find. Sometimes you know, the IP addresses you know, gets screwed up for some reason. Maybe it's something to do with our stereo home system sort of crashed. It was pretty old, so, and I was like unplugging things and plugging back things, you know, back and forth, and maybe something happened then. It wasn't really my intention, but just have to do that. So what do we have? What do we have? Stage 3, lap it up. Seaside sprint, I've done that before. I think I was 5th. It'll take half an hour of gruesome pain. And considering I have put about 110 kilometers in this week, I'm pretty beat. In fact, I was so beat after Wednesday, I I wasn't totally in a good mood, and it was all because of the ride, because it was so hard. But yes, rides will do that to you. It will make you tired. Okay, what to expect here? I don't really know. It looks like there's a lot of people. Didn't really expect a lot of people at this point of the season on Swift, and I'm positively surprised. There are a lot of people here. So, hey, let's try to aim for the sought after podium. But a top 10 would be fine. And I'm speaking Swift power, of course. Nothing else matters. Yeah. And here's another depressing fact. When I quit doing Swift last March or April, I had a good feeling that I would get that Tron bike. I have not. Why? Well, I haven't been doing any climbing because I have been racing. So everything counts, but it's just when you don't do up the Swift and stuff like that a lot, there is certainly a long way for to get the Tron bike. So maybe next year, right? Season goes by pretty quickly, right? So I'm nearly there. I think I'm like at 85%. So where did I start then, you say? Oh, good question. 70? 15% increase for a year? It's gonna be there. I'm gonna be there, like, it's gonna be close. Next year. I thought this year, but next year, I guess. It doesn't really matter. It looks cool. So, I was saying I didn't really care for avatars and funny bikes and weird wheels, but the Tron thing is something I drool over a little bit, because I really want that one. But it wasn't really something I was aiming for this year. I was just, you know, tagging along, doing the races. Speaking of races, I won two. I think I won two. Yeah, I won two. A few podiums. Not as much as last season. Does that mean that I've become worse, or does that mean that people are just better? Both, maybe. Or just being a bit unlucky, I don't know. I just looked at my numbers, and they don't differ that much from last season. But for those who have turned 30 or even 40, there is only one way, and that's down. Because it's going to be very hard to get better at this, right? It's the body will sort of slow you down a little bit. So, but I'm pretty sure I can keep this up for few more seasons at least, at the same pace, and then I will, heck, you know, you see all these guys on Swift like 50 plus, you know, kicking my ass, so you never know. They do. But then there's the weight to watts ratio there. It's always a bit confusing for those who try to understand this, and I stopped to understand this. I just do this. I do this for a living. No, I don't. Okay. Okay, you've got 5 minutes to go. So, how's the weather been? Cold. How's the rides been? Cold but long. Any energy issues? No, actually it was surprisingly... because a few seasons ago I usually, you know, I end up doing too much too soon, and I was aware of that this year, so I've been trying to hold back a little bit. And if I can keep doing Swift just a little bit once a week or a few times a month, I can keep this going too, because it's the endurance thing that I need to work on. It's the long rides, right? The long rides, that's the thing. It won't, those 20k ride like this won't really matter for what I'm supposed to be doing. So it's all about endurance, boys and girls, but it's good. I've done some PRs on Strava, and they've come to be a surprise, but it's the wind, obviously. I was like doing one climb, and I've been working on that climb for several seasons, just trying to get a little bit better at it. It's a really fun one. And suddenly I just PR'd it, and I didn't even try. I was just like, you know, aiming for a good time. I wasn't like thinking, okay, here we go. It worked out. Okay, I think I'm gonna stop now. Do pay attention, do tag along for the outdoors, the great outdoors. I have some rides coming up which will be interesting and scenic, if that's your thing. So here we go. Let's just cross fingers that the connection will be okay. I'm gonna recheck the net, but I think it's too late now anyway, because I have connected myself like this, so yeah. Okay, let's go.
Not getting any connections.
Lost connection. Okay, I'm back to 5G. Jesus Christ. Yeah.